former South African international, Quinton de Nace, and Q's next to me. Interesting battle this one tonight.
Well, this is the benefit of the new format. The home and away game, I think, is going to be intriguing because adjustments have been made.
And then you can see Officer Rabat, Booster Rabat, of course, at the top with 2 wins from 2. Petro Luanda trying to play catch-up, and Cape Town Tigers looking for their first victory. Lots of things going on here, and we'll have lots of information coming from all over the court, including the side of the court, of course, with Asha Kumagisha. Asha, interesting battle this one.
Yeah, absolutely. Revenge is on the cards for Petro de Luanda, but let's see how FUS Rabat will react to this one.
Thanks very much, Asha. We'll be catching up with you a little bit later on. Petro Luanda looking for straight wins after their victory over the Cape Town Tigers, and it gives us a chance to hear from the two coaches, starting with the coach of FUS, Said El Bouzidi. Before we actually start, we catch up with the coach. Then we can see some of the key players. Buster Rabat, of course, Diarra being a very important player. Last game stats for Zuita, who is obviously going to be pivotal alongside Diarra Q.
Well, it literally speaks to the way they played the game. Zuita becoming the provider inside. He's 7 assists alongside 60% from the field. And what he showcased is his pedigree and his class, as well as his presence inside the paint. And you know why FUS have signed him, and what value he brings to them on the floor.
I can't hear anything. I can't hear anything.
This is sure pure movie. So it's aggressive. So
yeah, we need to... we need to be more aggressive than the first game. We're obliged to play and win, play to win all of the matches for us to get a chance to get ourselves into the finals in Rwanda. And we need to play better than the last game. And we need to win the match. Let's take a look at the starting five for Booster Rabat.
The dynamic John Jordan leading the way from the point guard position. Backcourt, his partner Kendrick Brown getting the start. Nui, and of course he needs no introduction, the MVP, defensive player of the year in terms of Aliyu Diarra. And we just had a look at that man, Zuita. That front court is dynamic. They play fantastic basketball, and they've been proving a handful to all of the defenses in this conference.
Well, we've seen that Booster Rabat. Now it's time to take a look at Petro de Luanda. Now, of course, Petro de Luanda, we've got certain players to stand out from the crowd. Yannick Moreira has been a player who's taken the spot of Johnny Petro.
Well, he's going to have his hands full for sure on the defensive end, but it's also his ability to facilitate scoring. You see the 8 rebounds. He's going to be working on the glass very hard against Aliyu Diarra inside the paint, but he's going to have a huge role to play. He's got to stay on the floor, and he's got to put out production like this for coach Jose Neto.
We got a few big boys in the paint. Let's hear from Jose Neto, the Brazilian coach at the helm of Petro de Luanda.
Oh, it's a tough game. They play hard, they play good basket, and they play as a team like us. I believe that the basketball need to play. So we learned some things in the first game, and now we need to put in on the game what you learned, and play better as a team and defense hard, no allowed too much easy points. So I think you need to play better defense, and so we can play better.
According to you, what could make the difference in that game?
Oh, I believe that the intensity. They played too much intensity with in the first game. But now I think we learned with this, and now I think we can play tonight a better game, our style, and play as a team. So I think we can play better in this night.
Good luck, coach.
Well, played better, of course. 100-88, the victory over the Cape Town Tigers. But the starting five didn't change from that starting five against the homeboys.
Absolutely unchanged. And I think the offensive output, as we outlined in terms of Moreira inside the paint, will be one of the primary battles. But legend Carlos Moraes leading this Kalahari Conference in three-point shooting. 8 made threes on 44%, and look for the sharpshooter to be on target from the outside, or that's the hope for him.
Pretoria is the place to be. Pretoria, it's here now, and we are into this entertaining moment of this competition when we take a look at Zuita, of course, in the last game. This is what he racked up, Q.
A fantastic work by Zuita, and it's those 7 assists, his ability to pass outside the paint, and it's going to be even tougher against that man, Moreira.
Back to the game. Tip off, and we're already moving into the slipstream. FUS de Rabat up against Petro de Luanda, and the Angolan Giants with Carlos Moraes under a little bit of pressure. Gonsalves chucks it back. A little bit wild, a bit of a wild pass. Moraes driving into the paint. A floater over the top, doesn't fall, picked up, and a good chance to go again. And again, it's this time Moreira unable to sink it. Jordan. First points for FUS de Rabat. No, he gets the second bite of the apple, potentially.
We're getting our first look at the ferocity of the matchup inside the paint, and we keep an eye on Moreira and Diarra.
Zuita goes up, off the metal, the iron, whatever you like to call it, doesn't matter, it's orange. Long-range shot, Gaku. Oh, there's three misses already with three phases of attack, but Jordan puts it up, and there's a little tip in. Oh, it just can't just get it in. Diarra unable to use those silky fingertips, and Moraes. Can we get our first points from Gaku? Gaku nails the two using brute force.
Well, we've seen some transition opportunities, and that's a nice find from Moraes, not really allowing the defense to settle in. A nice two for Gaku inside.
Well, as you can see, it's going to be a very interesting matchup between Kendrick Brown and Dundao in that backcourt.
You've noticed that already, have you, Asha? Us too.
As a promise. Former guard, I can see.
No, big time. I mean, you know, this is one of the duels, many duels that will be taking place here. But keep our eyes on that one, a big way. Twitter again trying to go up. Well, how he managed to just swat that back into his teammate's hands, Louis. Drive through, good score, big time, Twitter. You get onto the hashtag, of course, and the BAL. Get on all of the socials if you're keen as mustard. Everybody's as keen as mustard to get involved in this BAL. Season 4 coming at you. Kalahari Conference.
BAL for the game. Kalahari Conference here for the first time in South Africa.
We love it, Q. We love it. Oh, there's dispossessed. Well, he does well, doesn't he, Gaku, with all of the points for the Angolan Giants so far.
Hustle points on that one, just right place, right time for the easy two for Gaku.
Hustle, muscle, moving, dynamic. Oh, you can't take your hand, your eyes off the ball, sir. Dundao's cobra fast hands get there.
It's a two-time defensive, all-defensive player in the Basketball Africa League taking on Ken Brown. He's going to have his afternoon full, and Asha was correct. It's a key matchup.
She knows her stuff. Here we go. Ken Brown around Dundao. There's a little bit of an offensive movement of that right shoulder, knocking Dundao to the ground.
This might be two of the quickest players with ball in hand in the Basketball Africa League, and it's going to be fascinating. Foot speed is definitely going to be on display.
I thought you were just going to say in Africa over the past 20 years, which included you.
Look, potato, potato.
He didn't see that coming, did he?
No, I flanked him from the left side, coming off the baseline. Here they go, Gonsalves, and it's been stolen, pinched up, picked up, taken up by Nuhi, and he gives the ball into the hands of Brown. Great drive, great score.
Important score.
And Jordan's on the radar as we see Coach Neto there, just walking up and down, pacing, understanding exactly what's happening. FUS de Rabat, of course, beat Petro de Luanda 73-82 in that opening encounter of the Kalahari Conference. So we've basically got an understanding of how these two teams play. But this is a different battle altogether now, Q, isn't it?
And Petro started a little bit slower. And that's a three.
Big three, isn't it? Just outside of the arc. Went up. Yes, you're firing in the right way, brother.
Petro were chasing the game in that opening encounter. It looks like they're a little bit more locked in and they're trying to set the tempo.
They need to be up against this FUS team. Long range shot coming off. You heard the sound, didn't fall. It's not that silky, lovely sound of the net. Contact, connection. Oh, Just touched by Diarra, goes out of play. They'll get possession back.
Well, Coach Jose Neto in the pregame interview was saying that there's something areas that he identified. The board's definitely one of them. They were out-rebounded 42 to 34, and they've already done a better job here in the first quarter.
Dundao back out to Gaku. Dundao, watch out for the quick movement. Moreira picks it up, tries to get around Diarra's. Where's he going to go? He's going to go himself. Tries to hook it over the top, and that is a fine score indeed, but I'm not too sure if it... Does it count?
It looks like he's going to get the continuation and the score, and that might be another foul for Diarra. And you have a look at the matchup here. Strong take, outstretched arm. Could have been at the top or the bottom. Zuita coming in on the help. And that looks Zuita. Either way.
Yeah, I think so. He kind of sandwiched, wasn't he? In any case, he's going to the free throw line. And logically, there's a timeout that's been called, of course. And this is going to be important for the FUS Rabat coach and players to get a little bit of a chit-chat. 4 points for FUS Rabat and 9 for Petro Luanda. And we will be back in a moment. Don't go away, people.
Can you do something for me? Can you hit a little wrist flex for me? 21, can you do something?
At Rwandair, every flight is a journey of commitment. We prioritize the transportation of our customers' goods. Our cold storage facilities maintain freshness for perishables throughout the journey. Our warehouse is designed to handle a diverse range of goods with care and efficiency. Our team is committed to ensuring every aspect of your shipment is handled with precision and care. We comply with industry standards, implementing rigorous quality control measures to guarantee the safety and security of your cargo. Our fleet's cargo compartments provide ample space to accommodate a variety of products. We commit to timely delivery, ensuring your goods arrive fresh. From safely handling your cargo to providing updates, our team is always here for you.
We are now in Akagera National Park. It's a home of the Big Five.
I fell in love in Kigali. People like to enjoy life.
This was my dream since I was a kid, working with the gorillas every day.
There is something really magical about Nungwe National Forest. This is our little piece of heaven.
Rwanda is a place that everybody should really visit.
Welcome to Rwanda.
So the Moroccans have 4 points and Petro Luanda with 9, and it is the Angolan champions. They won the Angolan championship 16 times, for crying out loud. They know exactly what they're doing. They've stormed into a good position here, and they're not allowing FUS Rabat to start quickly.
Two heavyweights, and if we're looking at the scoring, then definitely the Angolan heavyweight champions, and that's going to be another chance for Moreira. They've got FUS on the back foot just a little bit.
Absolutely. Usher, we're coming over to you because we know that you've been, you've got special secret agent skills, picking up so much over the course of a game that, you know, we're just like going, wow, what have you got?
Coach Saeed El Bouzidi emphasizing on that ball movement on the offensive side. He wants to see them get their best option on every possession. Let's see if they'll execute here.
Yeah, absolutely. Very important. They've got to stay disciplined as well. They've got 3 fouls compared to Petro without any. Jordan goes up. He's got such great jump skills, hasn't he? You know, he's got springs in his sneakers.
His vertical is astounding, and it's something that everybody's getting excited about.
Long-range shot coming off the metal, tidied up by Carlos Moraes, takes it up court. Dundao in front of him, lots of options. Moreira picks it up in the paint, tries to get around. Diarra goes for the little turn and over the top, doesn't fall, and another chance for Gaku. Bit of contact there on Zuita, I believe.
Going into this game over just 2 games, and I know it's a small sample size, FUS Rabat leading the conference in points in the paint and presence in the paint, and you see that the Angolan champions, they are going inside with Gaku and Moreira, and they're getting a lot of touches, trying to counteract what we've seen as a style of play from FUS.
Well, there's Zuita, and he has picked up a first foul there, of course. So 4th there for FUS Rabat. They're being a bit physical. Gaku, I like the way that he's come into this start of the first quarter, because he hasn't really sort of, you know, he hasn't lit up the courts just yet, and we just know how dangerous that guy is, not just because of his size, long-range shots, but also, you know, he just fits into that cog, doesn't he?
Well, if you're going to penetrate the paint, the primary scouting report will be around Moreira. I don't think they thought that Gakpo would impact the game in this way.
Yeah, well, that's what you do. You just camouflage with other options, don't you? You know what it's like, Hugh.
I do.
Diarra. Well, more contact off the ball. And it's Gonsalves who'll pick up the first foul for Petro. Just look at that, getting tangled up with Jordan, who's a wily character, isn't he? And it makes, gets Ken Brown picking a little bit of space mid-range too. It's a sumptuous score there.
Finds a spot just off the pick, gets to the elbow, and it's a comfortable opening jump shot for Ken Brown.
3 from 10, 4 from 8, field goals. Dundau, another player we're looking to try and see him move himself up, and well, Jordan just easily took that away. Look how fast he was to get in front of Moreira.
Great anticipation from Brown, just understanding what the intent was, picks up the steal.
Brown, not Jordan, get your names right, sir. That was for me, that was. Into the paint, and a little bit of contact there on Ayoub Nuhi, and he'll go to the free throw line.
Well, it looks like FUS just starting to settle into their pattern of play, trying to figure out ways to get inside the paint. And Nui, liking his matchup against Moraes, goes right at the chest, and he draws the foul.
Yeah, you can just see one of the most decorated players on the continent, Carlos Moraes, of course, just he was still stumbling backwards, so there was contact. And he didn't have his feet cemented onto the court, what did he?
He didn't, and a little bit of foot race that no, he won, but also just great fundamentals to go right at the chest. Moraes is making his third run at a BAL title, and he's looking to try and advance past the hurdle, and I think the whole coaching staff and the whole of Angola is hoping that they can.
And they get, well, it's big news coming from Angola, because the AfroBasket will go back to Angola next year, 2025, so lots of great basketball action coming to this wonderful basketball mad country. Went to the hands, that's beautifully done! Nui! Smashing and crashing it in, what a dunk, one hand, in it goes.
Defense to offense, that's transition basketball at the highest level.
Beautiful link-up play. That pass there from Jordan was top quality as well, as Moreira goes up, doesn't fall, Diarra makes it safe. It goes again. Look at this. This is exceptional. And that is a foul there from Gakpo. And Zoita unable to get it down. We're going to see what the outcome of that is.
So it becomes interesting. I think they're going to count the bucket for interference. And another look here. Eric Nui takes off. And another one of those posters added to the BAL poster series in season 4.
Well, the highlight reel will definitely look good on Instagram today.
It's not that, it's just getting too big now, is it? There's just so much content coming from this fourth season. The Kalahari kids are showing off, Q.
They certainly are, and the fans in the house are appreciating it.
We are too. We're loving it every single second as that man Zuita goes up, sinks the first, back for another. And look at this, they've clambered back, 10-12.
And they needed to clamber back. They had gone a little bit cold from the field, and the way you clamber back, and you'll hear the cliche, possession by possession, you've got to get stops, and that's what they've done.
Gentlemen, it's just a great opportunity now to introduce the referees of the day, Kevin Fahy, who brings a lot of experience from the NBA G League, is American, Arnold Moseya from South Africa, and Monica Nasuna from Uganda.
Thank you so much, Asha. Thank you for getting that. Very important to name the names of the officials who are doing such a top quality job here in this fourth edition of the BAL. We've seen it every season, getting better in every single way, and it's been great from a and constant, and I think that's a key word, isn't it, for refereeing, at such a high level league, being constant.
It's the most unappreciated job here at the Basketball Africa League, also the most difficult. So to stay constant is a very good thing.
I think you can agree with that, Asha, can't you?
Yeah, absolutely. As a maybe upcoming referee, you know, maybe one day you guys will see me here.
Yeah. No, don't get a whistle. No, you'll just be whistling at me all the time. You know, Bobby, stop that. No,
I'll stay with the breaking news then.
Yeah. Oh, you'd be a good referee as well.
Woo-hoo.
Straight back to free throw line. Gaku is the man. 11-13. And Nui with 3 points. It's Gaku got seven, and that's a great layup as well. Beautifully done. Mohamed Sylla coming on.
He's had a definite impact, Mohamed Sylla, the young Elevate player. He comes in, gives them additional scoring, and you, of course, can't teach 7 feet of height.
You cannot. He has got the wingspan of an African albatross. Here we go with Gaku in the corner for three.
Confidence coming from his inside play. He goes to double digits with 10 points on that make from the outside, and they can continue to ride the hot hand in terms of Gaku.
Hot hands, scorching hot hands. Diarra gets a pass out to Nuhi. He's going up for a big three as well this time. Just bounces, comes off the metal. Already back down in action. Carlos Moraes is a player that hasn't managed to get himself the points just yet. Just Sylla, nice pass to Jordan. Jordan down in the corner, goes up, can't get it under and up and over, and there is a foul on Sylla.
Attacking the glass and trying to get second chance opportunities is important, and they've been able to do that. It's part of his impact, part of his height, and here's a look at Gaku on the catch, shoot, and hit. His first and pass into space. Diarra playing provider this time, and that is just excellence in execution.
Well, you talk about excellence. I think Sylla, just seeing the game earlier of his BAL Elevate teammates, got inspired, and now he's just continuing to show the amount of talent that we have on the African continent.
Thank you, Asha. We agree. We all agree with each other here, because we all just talk the talk. And I think that it's, you know, we've got to understand what's actually happening here in South Africa with the Elevate players, but also, you know, the new coming teams that are coming and getting their first taste of this BAL here in the Kalahari Conference. Fuster Rabat saying, we're not here just to make up the numbers. We're here to play, to score, to win. And that is the way that they communicate and they talk. They really are up for it, Q.
Well, it also speaks to the strength of the relative leagues. They have just come in and lit up the Basketball Africa League.
And now goes up. Oh, there's a rebound. A good chance to get the... No, they're going to get possession, but out of play, I think. Unable to keep that ball, Moreira, but... A fast break, Dundau unable to sink the two.
It encourages debate across countries in terms of which leagues are the strongest, and this is where you can get a measure of which leagues do the best consistently.
You know, it's Fuster Rabat, they've only lost one of their last 18 games, and you know, that is just incredible. It's against Sally, of course, they're rivals. But you know, they won their first 2 years, so they're already in a very comfortable position coming into this third encounter against Petro de Luanda. And, you know, they're here for business, as I said.
You talk about winning being a habit, and that is something that they've established.
They look good. They look very organized. That's nicely done by Medin. Look at that. Sylla with a dunk. Oh, wow.
Fantastic. And this is a feature of their play, the extra pass for the finish.
And the attempt at a long-range shot from downtown from Gaku, who's got the hot hands, but not on that occasion. Let's look at the replay.
Draws two defenders, drops off to the seven-footer. He certainly knows how to finish, gets up, over, and he puts it in.
Well, you talked about Fus Rabat being able to deal with the two giants there, Moreira and maybe later Pedro. Bringing in Sylla sort of gives them that size and the paint, and so far he's delivering.
This man here, like Said El Abouzidi, he's done a brilliant job, because he's actually brought in players to complete the family. In fact, when you look at Nadja, Nui, Azuga and Bayeri, these are players who he's worked with before. He said, right, you're coming with me, because we're going to the BAL. And he's actually just he's handpicked his players perfectly to get that right, the right ingredients to move in the right direction. So it's basically just, you know, getting back together and working again as a unit.
You know, we often talk about chemistry. Chemistry is trying to get the coach's vision visibly seen on the floor, and he's got to find the pieces that help bring his vision to life, and that takes some time. And that's why what you're talking about, Robbie, is probably behind the thought process that we see for the way the team was composed.
And talking about composition, the minute they won the league last year, they started their rebuild in June, and you only have two players here in the Kalahari Conference that won that league title, and that is Sofiane Benmini and Zuita. The rest brand new, but the team chemistry and the and what they've been able to showcase here is what you call genius from El Bouzidi.
Yeah, he's just got invisible glue, isn't he, Asha?
Absolutely.
You weren't ready for that, were you? I don't even know where that came from either. In fact, he's working his magic, and that's, you know, it's Moroccan magic at its best.
Yes, he is basketball royalty in Morocco, but El Bouzidi.
Absolutely. Petro, high off the glass. That's an absolute delight there from Carlos Maes.
Now that is lots of experience, lots of skill. And he was under a lot of duress.
Picked up here by Bairi. Goes out wide. Azuga's come onto the court. Jordan tries to keep it safe and away from Dundau. Little swing pass behind the head. Long range shot doesn't fall from Azuga. Picked up by Dundau. Look how quick he's going up court. He's going himself. Oh, you won't catch him. He's as fast as lightning.
He forced the defense to make a decision. No one got up in front of him. It opened up and he finished with his left hand for two easy points.
You can't run faster than lightning, Q.
No, you can't.
It is simple, basic physics.
Bouyamba just getting caught up and snagged by Yassine Bairi.
Another look at this play from Dundau. Gets in front of the defense. They have to make a decision. He had the option of Gaku right open, and it made it look easy.
Bairi. We thought, okay, this is a really strong start from Petro. Fuster Rabat coming back in and basically throwing themselves into the situation. And they've clawed back. And we're all level here at 20 points apiece in this battle to see basically, you know, who could potentially finish in the top spot. We're not there yet, but there's still basketball left to be played. Oh, that's a big crash fall, that is, as the big drive there from Moraes. He hits the ground hard.
And it's always difficult and dangerous, especially in midair. Moraes takes that baseline lane, and the contest comes up and across. Body contact sees him go down to the ground hard.
Well, he's touching his lower back, but let's see if he can get up.
Azuga, yeah, hitting that contact hard on the defensive end.
Yeah, he's coming in and then he's putting his back there. So he was off balance when he was going up for the score, of course. Back up on his feet, which is great news. And he's just a little bit of a back movement there. But he's back up and he's ready to take the shots from the free throw line. Great news for Petro. It's not a player you want out of this squad at any cost.
Not at all. He's been fantastic again. Leading the conference, like I said, in three-point made. He's got eight makes in two games, and he's shooting it at 44%, which is better than any of the players that we've seen showcased in the Kalahari Conference.
Now here, Q, I know that you like, you know, gold. You've got those El Dorado-like sort of, you know, sneakers that you wear sometimes, but he does as well. He's got a whole bag of gold, in fact, Carlos Moraes. Four Afro basket gold medals with Angola, just to understand exactly what he's actually achieved. We'll get back onto the court and sort of, you know, talk about what's happening here.
Well, Cummings has been given a technical foul by crew chief Kevin Fahey for a reaction after that call. And looks like it will be a shooting on the free throw for Fusraba.
It should be a single shot, and descent is often frowned upon by the referees on the floor, and a little push in the back there. Cummings trying to pick up the rebound. And that's where he
tossing
picked
the
up
ball,
the tech.
He's throwing the ball there. He's throwing the ball towards Azuga and the ref. And I think that, you know, you just can't do that. You know, you've got to just keep a lid on your temper. But that's a problem because he's... Cummings has got, first foul, in fact.
Tense moments. That was... Technical foul is confirmed. And ejected from the game. That's going to be the end of the evening for Cummins.
Well, this is that's a big blow for Petro Luanda, hence the reason why he was like complaining. But the fact that he threw the ball towards the referee is, and the push in the back.
And I suppose there might have been extra descent. So the first technical foul would have been for the ball push, and then additional descent would have seen two ticks. So they will probably shoot two, and that sees him leave the floor.
Drama here in the Kalahari Conference as we see Yassine Bairi go up to the free throw line.
Just a quick update from the Petro de Luanda bench as Carlos Moraes gets treatment for his lower back. It looks like he'll come back into this game. The coach will have to make a decision.
Well, as we said before, Usha, super important to this team, you know, in many more reasons than one. And they'll need him in this squad. And he's not the only one getting a little bit of treatment, as we saw Ayub Nuhi just getting a bit of a massage on that back. So, you know, there's a whole bunch of scenarios and situations that really sort of, you know, we're looking at here. And the first quarter is not even over.
No, it's definitely created a lot of scenarios and situations, puzzles that Coach Jose Neto has now got to work around, because that's a big piece, and not having Cummins for the rest of this game. And that's 30 minutes he's got to utilize or find some extra minutes for and go deeper into his rotation.
We'll score at 21 points each. 1 minute 10 left in the first quarter. And Fusta Rabat with Jordan. Silla on court as well. Ben Mahin picks it up on the left-hand side, gets rid of his man, goes up. Oh, it's absolutely top-notch there from Ben Mahin.
Poise, composure, and good decision from Mahin.
Dundau into the last minute we go. Anthony Nelson getting his first moments on court. Johnny Pedro as well, driving through the paint and gets tangled up with that man, Silla.
Well, got to keep an eye on some of these fouls now as it starts to continue to build. And you look at the ball fake, gets the defender in the air, blows by, takes his time, sets his eyes, feet, hits the shot.
And what do we got at the end?
You tell me.
Yeah, you tell me.
Your flamingo hands.
Oh, there you go. Exactly that.
You forced me to say it.
Yeah, I did. That was twisting your arm. Kiwi would never do that. Usher, I would never do that, right?
Yeah, I'll never do that. But just a quick update from the FUS Rabat bench, talking to Hariri, the physiotherapist, about, you know, that spray on El Nuhi's shoulder. It's just because he's, you know, come off the court, and he could be cold, you know, from just sitting on the bench. So it's just to make sure that he's okay.
Yeah, and that's really important, you know, just to make sure that everybody's in the right spot and, you know, and ready to go, of course. We see a lot of physio activity on the body. Berry going up for a big long-range shot that just comes off the metal on the other side. And Jordan a little bit frustrated with that because they're not going to get possession.
We've seen this scenario happen before, Robbie. When the intensity and the physicality increases on the floor, the referee's frequency, blowing of their whistle increases because they've got to take a little bit of control. But we've seen a lot of fouls blown for in this first quarter.
And we go straight up to the free throw line, of course. Jordan picks up his second. So it'll be Buyamba with a chance to try and put two more points as this... Well, it's a bit of a roller coaster ride. It's the accordion effect of, you know, I'm going to lead. No, I want to take the lead. I want to finish off the quarter. And both coaches, they really are itching to get the right results so that they can go into that little break and say, right, okay, this is where we are, guys.
I'm talking about both coaches, sorry, Q there. You look at the strategy they're using. They bring in what you call second phase of players and just leaving one player from the starting five, Jordan, and just to see how they can manage the end of this first quarter.
Thank you very much, Shasha. We're into the last 18 seconds. The bench of FUS Rabat, very strong indeed, as Jordan goes up, tries to lift it up. Great jump, great height, but can't find his the points. Another chance as the clock ticks away. Last chance for Nelson, maybe. Nelson goes out, tries to get the backboard, and it doesn't fall. And we have a very level encounter here. 25 points each at the end of the first quarter. Lots of drama, lots of entertainment, and a player who's actually been excluded from this, Markeith Cummings from Petro Luanda. We're going to take a small break, and then we'll come back and talk about what happened in that first quarter and move into the second. It's 25-all FUS Rabat Petro Luanda.
We need you to cheer if they're going in the right direction, and boo if they're going in the wrong direction. Set it now to Slim to meet our contestants.
All right, South Africa with me is Pumzile, all the way from Pretoria, my man Nani, who will be competing. Are you ready? All right, mom, you see, caballero. Aria, aria. Come on, bro. Please remember. Crowd, I need you to help me. Remember, she goes the wrong way, you boo. The right way, you cheer. Point. Go. Boo. Remember when they say yes. Boom, when they say yes. Boom. Okay. Yeah. 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 All right. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for our winner. We appreciate you. Make some noise and let's get ready for the second quarter of FUS Rabat up against Kalahari.
Welcome back to the Sunbet Arena here in Pretoria, here in South Africa. Let's have a look at the game stats between these two teams so far, Q.
As far as individual output is concerned, Mohamed Silla coming in off the bench. 8 points and 14 bench points for FUS Rabat. Zuita with 4 of his own. Abubakar Kaku had the hot hand to start out for Petro de Luanda, and they started to compile a little bit more synergy as the quarter unfolded, but it's as even as far as both these teams are concerned, and we're tied at 25.
Asha, we're coming over to you.
Yeah, just looking at the stats, of course, FUS Rabat scoring 12 points from the first break. They want to continue to do that. Coach El Bouzidi wants them to continue to play good defense so they can have the easy baskets in transition.
Asha's like she's got a computer-like brain. It's just like stats galore. They're just queuing up, aren't they, just to come out?
I'm watching you from the corner of my eye.
Okay, I'm going to hide myself from now on.
No, big hugs.
25-25, FUS Rabat, Petro Luanda, and it is the Moroccan champions who have possession. Jordan, he's got that man Silly, you just mentioned him, Q, he's on fire. Ben Mahin with a drive, stops. Good block there from Nelson, and here we go. It's a turnover ball. Nelson passed to Johnny Pedro. Oh, that was delightful. And everybody just watched him just drive through. Couldn't get the points. Jordan gets caught up. And there's a long-range shot from down in the corner there, fired in from Bayeri.
Third chance opportunity again, working the glass hard.
Nelson with the rebound again, Q.
They finally clean it up and control the possession, Petro de Luanda.
Frantic start, just like we saw in the start of the first quarter, where we had lots of coast-to-coast activity, but no points going in. What a wonderful pass out down in the corner. Just doesn't sink from Nelson. And Jordan, the dynamic Jordan. The JJ effect in full swing. Ben Mahin Shot clock down to five, need to make. They need to take a shot, it's not gonna happen. There you go, shot clock violation as Zazuga picks it up out wide.
We're going into a bit of a zone here, Petro de Luanda, and it's proved effective. The ball was moving around for that entire possession without any paint penetration, and we'll see how FUS will continue to attack the zone as the quarter develops.
Well, that's a fast and frantic start. We still haven't had any points scored in numerous opportunities at each end of the court, but Petro de Luanda in possession here. Nelson. Out wide, Gakou. Gaku's the man. Gakou hits a beautiful three.
He has been locked in for sure. 13 points, his second connection from long range.
Ken Brown isolated down in the corner. A little bit of support. Nadja, the experienced Nadja. Look at him trying to move himself. Spins, gets the two. Nicely done from the veteran.
That's a great bit of individual work by Nadja. And he got to a position that was comfortable for an easy two.
Domingos coming on.
FUS Rabat just haven't hit from long range, and that's why Petro comfortable in the zone.
That's beautifully done, isn't it? Just floating it over the top there from that man Domingos, getting his first points in the BAL Kalahari Conference. Oh, Jordan. Thought there was contact there by... No, it's a travel call, in fact.
Almost using his athleticism to steal a possession. He is a marvel to watch with that vertical. And you just look at Ken Brown driving in here, cross pass, oh my, gets up so high, I think it astounds everybody and it goes into a state of shock.
I thought he was gonna just hang in the air Matrix style and actually sort of, you know, find his 2 points. Not the case. I think we're gonna take a small break. There's so much going on here. 27-30, Petro de Luanda are the team that have just sneaked themselves ahead. We'll take a small break, right?
Welcome back to the Sunbet Arena, Pretoria. A tussle? Oh yeah, we got a big tussle. Abubakar Gakou is a man on a mission.
An improvement on the field. You see that 17% from the field in the last outing, and he has just been the go-to guy as far as Petro de Luanda are concerned.
Jota Pedro into the hands of Nelson. Ben Mahin putting pressure on him. Nadja's there. Oh, he couldn't pick the ball up, and it's anybody's. But it's Nelson who's done the really good job. Swatted down there by Diarra. And Nelson goes down, and a bit concerning. I'm just trying to see if there was contact by Diarra. There isn't. It was just...
So I think they called the goaltender, even though the ball's on a path down. It didn't look like it was going in, but they still do call the goaltender, and it's 2 points to Petro, and it's going to be FUS possession.
So they got a 5-point lead there. Ben Mahin down in the corner, Nadja. Way over to Brown, plenty of time. Ben Mahin gets rid of his man, Gakou. Nadja goes up for a mid-range two, another pair of points for the big man.
And this is a better ploy for FUS. They are the worst three-point shooting team in this conference. They struggle from the outside. They've got to continue to find ways, innovative ways to score inside the key area.
Nelson down into
to the right-hand side. Here he goes, Gakou, unable to sink the big long-range shot, Ben Maheen. And I think there's a bit of contact there from Gerson Domingos.
There's a lot of deliberation that is happening in and around contact situation.
Look at Domingos. He's just got his left hand just wrapped around that man, Ben Maheen, so he'll pick up his first foul.
It's a good spot, Robbie, and that's exactly what they call. But I think they're going to review.
The call on the floor is under review for a possible upgrade.
So unsportsmanlike foul, potentially, just because if he's
got to show intent, got to go for the basketball, and I think that's what they're just going to go and review.
Yeah.
Got to make an attempt to try and knock away the ball, and if it looks like he's gone for the mat, they will upgrade.
Yeah, and it's not like an upgrade on an aeroplane, is it, Q?
I wish it would upgrade on an airplane.
It's not the same. Asher, you'll be with us in a couple of moments as well, just because you're listening in. So we'll come to you in a moment. But just getting the replay there to understand exactly what that tangled up moment was like.
There's the referees, Arnold Mosea and Monica Nasuna, having a look at it. And they'll tell us the decision after. I mean, I wish if I was a referee, I would tell you for sure, guys. But let's leave it to the professionals.
Yeah, we will, and we'll be with a moment. And with that breaking news on the side of the court from Usher, and 6:32 left in the second quarter. They're having a little bit of a huddle and a decision on what the call is, the final call. As we are. And we can say a little mention about the 80,000 jacaranda trees that blossom in springtime here makes this city absolutely picturesque and beautiful.
The Jacaranda City is what it's called, and when the jacarandas are in blossom, that usually means the students and the scholars are all getting ready for exams. It's synonymous.
Part of the calendar year.
100%.
Love it. Do you know the original jacaranda seeds that came for the first trees? They came from Brazil.
Now that I didn't know.
Yeah. And they were nursed in Pretoria before they were planted, and then it all took off.
Well, that's why you have this wonderful geographical and this is botanical knowledge as well.
Botanical, there we go. Planting the seeds for the future. Here we go. This is Nui getting the ball out. Brown drops the ball. Oh, he goes high. There's Diarra again. Good block. Another chance. Nadja rolling around, round, and down.
That is where they are really sublime. Inside the paint, second and third chance opportunities getting conversions.
There's 31-32. So they clamber back. Is Bouyamba going around the outside? He's a tricky player to deal with. Diarra making the block. Gakou gets it out wide. Nelson 4-3, and it doesn't go. It's been tended and dealt with at the back. Brown isolated. Nice pass out wide. Ben Maheen with the shot, but it doesn't go.
We've seen two great possessions, making the extra pass, finding the shooter wide open, and they just couldn't knock down those opportunities.
Nelson, that's a stunning two-pointer just inside of the arc, shooting perfectly.
Finding a flow in his offense. Nelson trying to will himself into this offense of Petro de Luanda.
Ben Maheen gets it back. Here's Brown once again, gets the block from Diarra. Ball comes out wide, good opportunity. Nadja picks it up. Oh, comes off the side of the backboard there. And it's been picked up by Nelson. Nelson goes up, swatted away by Nadja. Stay out of my house.
Great defense again. This has been fantastic work by both of these teams.
The offensive rebound is flying in. Ben Maheen just coming in, stooping in to try and sneak and pinch, and it doesn't happen. Nelson has the ball at the back as they go once again.
We have seen two of Africa's best teams really going at it, and it's been a really amazing showcase so far. It rivals what we saw on the opening day.
Well, let's just keep an eye on the clock, 4:43, 31:34, and so many things happening here at the moment. It's FUS Rabat with Nadja trying to get himself the right points. And it gives us a chance to go over to Usher, who's joined by the South African middle distance champion, two Olympic gold medals, three world championship titles, Caster Semenya, joined by Usher.
Well, we're joined by royalty. Caster, thank you so much for joining us. You have won medals worldwide at the Olympics, World Championships. But what does it mean for South Africans that the BAL is here in Pretoria?
I think it means a lot. So it's a way to develop sports. As much as we say, you know, sports is called the way to unite people. That's a way to unite us. It's something that we're looking forward to. We want to turn into pro. So, yeah, it's everything to us.
Well, Caster, I know you're a basketball fan. What's your favorite team in the NBA, and who's your favorite player?
I move with the individual, which is LeBron James, of course. He moved to L.A., I moved to L.A.
You know? Oh, wow, that makes the two of us.
Of course, of course. So, yeah, LeBron all the way.
And so far, how are you liking the action here tonight?
I love the atmosphere. I saw something there. I saw a block. I would love to see a lot of steals. I love to see someone dunking, so yeah.
Well, maybe after the game, we'll give you the ball and you can, you know, show us some of that talent.
I'll try to hoop a little bit, so yeah.
Thank you so much, Caster.
You're welcome, thank you.
Caster, we're going to get you on the court, I promise you. You know, you'll get your opportunity. Now that you've laid it down there, we're ready to go. And we know that you can keep it up for long distance, middle distance, whatever.
Once an athlete, always an athlete.
There we go. There we go. 33-36, and you can see that Petro have just nudged themselves ahead as we go into this timeout. Just trying to understand exactly sort of, you know, what kind of tactics are going to be taught between the players and the coaches. You know, what are they going to be working on to try and get themselves back out? Because, to be honest with you, both teams are playing very strong basketball so far.
Yeah, we are seeing a great, well-competitive, super competitive game. One area that continues to frustrate FUS is their inability to knock down long-range shots. They are now 0 of 10 from the three-point line, and there is absolutely nothing you can do other than continue to try and get open looks and go back to the same spots and just try and make the shot.
It's exactly that, isn't it? And we'll see how FUS the Rabat. So they're kind of moving. I wouldn't say they've got their finger on the pulse of what's happening out here so far, Petro Lana, but they find themselves in a good position. Now look at Nadja, 8 points, 4 from 4 field goals, looking very strong, but he's been so present in the paint when the ball's been dropped into his hands, and he's so strong and physical.
So they have like-for-like substitutions that they can bring in at any point in their rotation, and Nadja just comes and fits into that front court and gives production that's very similar to Zohita, very similar to the way that Diarra can, and you get that kind of production from that rotation in your team, and it puts you in a good place.
Very much a good place there, as we see Zuga just sat on his seat there, just watching on it, as Nui, he's the MVP for AS Sally in 2017 when they conquered Africa, of course. So still got lots of great basketball action to perform on the highest level as we see them in a bit of a chase.
Well, just one area that they have improved on is the free throw line. They had 8 for 20 in that win over the Cape Town Tigers. They're much better today.
Oh, great work from Jordan Petro, just making sure that Nadja wasn't an obstacle, using the great height and the experience to put those 2 points on the board.
2 more points to create just that 4-point separation, and they continue to fight possession by possession.
I love the way that Ken Brown just quickly takes the pass, moves out of the way, gets rid of his man quite quickly. That's nice and neatly done into the hands of Zoita. Ben Mahin goes up for a long-range shot, but I'm afraid that the clock told us that that wasn't going to go in.
The drought from the outside continues, and the struggle from the perimeter is real. The drop of Neto, beautiful drive in, no look, finds his big man, and Pedro right there to finish around the arms of the defender. A nice moment there for young Algenaro Neto, just getting inside and providing some production. Of course, the NBA elevate player.
Very important to get time on court and then provide us with a little bit of acceleration. Goes up. Oh, my word. That was like, you are coming nowhere near my backyard.
Trying to muscle his way in. That's supreme defense, really great timing, and Neto gets cleared out.
SWAT team in place. 34-38. Drive through, looking for a little bit of space and time. Dundao goes up for three, doesn't. There's contact by Bayeri on Boyamba, and, well, he will go to the free throw line.
Bayeri gets caught ball watching just a little bit late to react in the rotation. Boyamba ahead of him, nothing he could do other than foul.
Childe Dundao back on court. He's got a little bit of competition in that playmaker role, isn't he? Amongst the teammates that he's got on court. Gakou getting the ball out. Bayeri gets in the way. Otherwise, it would have been in the hands of the ever-dangerous, swashbuckling Boyamba.
When you talk about competition, it's healthy competition, because Neto, coming through the NBA Academy Africa, made his debut with the Angolan national team, and he's certainly being developed for the position.
Well, that's gone all the way. He's just picked the ball up before he goes into his side of the court, and shot clock down. High shot from Dundao to the right of the target, and it's Fuster Rabat who just quelled that attacking phase there on that moment.
That's a great defensive possession, forcing a poor shot from Petro de Luanda, and they keep the ball and a chance to make an inroad into the lead from the side of FUS.
2:20 left on the clock in this first half. Ken Brown picks the ball up, doesn't move as quickly as he usually does, but there he does, gets rid of Dundao. Out wide to Bayeri, cuts inside into the paint, ball over. Zoita unable to get it in, and it's been picked up. The target's been missed, and here he goes again. Great dangerous charge there from the youngster Neto. Neto finds Johnny Pedro around the outside. That is just sublime there from the 32-year-old Johnny Pedro.
Whether they're using him on the slash or allowing him to just put the ball on the floor from the top of the key, it's proving very effective.
Yeah, that was clinical stuff. I would call it surgical, I think. Nice pass up and around. Nacho can't get that touch off the glass, and it's a drive up the other. And look how quickly they're going. This is completely crazy. And you can see Neto's down on the ground. Contact by Nacho, I believe.
And basket interference called there by referee Arnold Musea. So they're going to count the bucket. There'll be no contact call. And Neto sliding by. That acceleration up court, getting by. You know, basket interference on the net, and they count the bucket.
Yeah, Nadja just touching the backboard there. So obviously, 2 points straight on the scoreboard, 34-42.
First 2 points for Neto in Petro de Luanda Cups.
Yeah, and in the BAL. That's great. We love that. 34-42. And how much left on the clock? 1:30 here. Get the content on Instagram and all of the socials. It's fantastic. You should get involved. You saw it. It's up on your screen. We'll put it up throughout this game, of course, so that you can get involved and chit-chat away and check out all of the videos that are there. It's top-notch content put together by the team, the BAL team. Drive through, and it's not going to happen. That was a good bit of blocking there just to stall him and thwart him, because he's a dangerous man, Nuhi, when he goes on a wonder.
They're looking and searching. There's possession pressure starting to build now as the scoring run builds. This actually favors Petro de Luanda. They are struggling to break down Petro's zone. Ball movement is not working for them. And what the zone has done is really just allow Petro to build a lead.
Neto Boyamba. Gakou. Neto, good movement from Petro as it all opens up. If he can get it high and dry away from the hands of the very tall Silla. That's a great score from Neto. Confidence is building, Hugh.
That is a superb read from young Alginaldo Neto. He's starting to find his version of confidence.
Dundao goes down. The foul's been committed offensively there by Jordan. And they've got a 10-point lead. They're sitting in a pretty comfortable position as they enter, as the halftime break approaches, of course.
We've talked about the importance of basketball runs, and you can see that Petro de Luanda are enjoying this one. Their body language is different from what we saw in their opening game against the same opponents earlier. And they're looking good, and they're feeling the rhythm.
They're feeling the rhythm indeed. JJ picking up the foul, of course, which is not great. That's his third, and that is a serious issue. That is for Fuster Rabat. It's the perfect scenario for Petro de Luanda as they start to find themselves in this CAL Kalahari Conference. Shot clock down to 7 seconds with Dundao. Dundao drives through, floats one over the top. And that is just sublime again, using the sky, using his perfect touch there.
Inside out, dribble and goes to the float. There's beautiful, beautiful score from Dundao.
12-point advantage here, stolen the ball once again. They can't allow their heads to drop. Fuster Rabat, otherwise they'll be playing, and they'll be playing against them, only against themselves. And with what, 4.7 seconds left on the clock, that is contact by El Hawa.
It's been a good last 3 minutes in this second quarter for Petro de Luanda. The push on the back, the hand on, forces the officials to make a call. And it's been all Petro for the last 3 minutes because they've just been sublime in creating defensive pressure from the zone, and they convert on the other side.
Timeout being called, of course, before we bring an end to the end of the first half. But you can see Dundao, what I'm seeing from Petro, standout performances from players who haven't really, you know, hit top gear just yet. Dundao, for me, I'm seeing the real Dundao that we saw in, you know, last season and in the other seasons, where he has just been, he's been plugged in, charged up electricity here.
When he allows the game to come to him and spearheads the offense a little bit, 7 points, Childe Dundao building on his performance against the Cape Town Tigers. Alginado Neto's had an impact coming in off the bench to pick up those 4 points, and they go on their biggest scoring run to create the separation and get the lead up to 12. Mohamed Silla, 8 points alongside Naja. The scoring has dried up for Fuster Rabat. Their field goal percentage on the inside, good, but the three-point line, they can't figure out the rhythm or the riddle of the three-point line. Kaku, 13 points, and then the rest of the Petro squad has started to chip in. Dundao, 7, Neto's 4, Nelson, 4, and Jone Pedro, 8.
That's great, isn't it? Aginaldo Neto coming, putting himself on the top 5 scorers, you know, and putting him up on the stats sheet is a great sign, you know, for Angolan basketball. When you see the youngsters coming through, you always say, yeah, they're shining, they're ready to go.
And you understand why there's so much excitement around the Elevate program and the NBA Academy Africa.
It's a massive buzz. Last chance before the end of the half. 2 seconds remaining. Dundao tries to go, it doesn't happen, and that's the end of the half. And, well, look at that. That's a great scoreline for Petro Luanda, but for Fuster Rabat and Said El Bouzadi, they need to pull their socks up and come into that third quarter hitting hard.
They certainly have to do that. It was a much better second half of the second quarter for Petro de Luanda. They figure out the mystery of the zone, Dufus Rabat, and they back in this one.
Turnover steals, doing really good. Lots of work in the paint as well. We'll take a break and we'll be back in a few moments with the highlights of the first half. It's 34-46. Petro in charge here in Pretoria.
Fans, keep up with the PL by going to the website at thepl.com and on social media all season long using the handle at thepl. And be sure to share your experiences from today's game by using the official hashtag thepl. All right, fans, now for your halftime show presented to you by Rwanda Air. She is a hip-hop award winner. She's an FIBA award winner, a BET nominee. She is young, famous, and African. Brought herself, Pretoria, make some noise for Nile Conference!
Yeah, I hope you guys are having a good time.
Come to you by visit Rwanda.
10, 10, 10, 10, 10. Never ballin' on a budget.
halftime show taking place here with Nadia Nakai. But FUS Rabat 34 and Petro Luanda 46. The highlights from the first half, as we see, early score there from Moreira.
It was early score from Moreira, but really Gaku leading the scoring in that first quarter for this Petro Luanda. A beautiful take and drive inside to finish with the left, and Zawita showcasing his versatility. He only had four in the first quarter. Fast break points help keep FUS Rabat in this one. They 12 of their fast break points coming, and this is two coming in exquisite style. As now he elevates and he detonates with one right hand duck.
Well, that's about a fourth attempt there before Diarra just gets a little touch to it at the end. And then, of course, some good strong goaltending at the back there. Nadja swiping it away to stop Nelson.
The drop-off pass, Alginaldo Neto building his confidence, finding the veteran Pedro inside the paint. And this is around the time that Petro de Luanda started to build the lead. 34-46, the score now at the half on the back of 33% shooting FUS Rabat. But let's have a look. Mohamed Silla, 2 of 2. He was for his 8 points and 6 rebounds. Abubakar Gaku, really the story in the first quarter to go along with those 13 points and 4 of 7 shots. Jone Pedro, effective inside the paint. Alginaldo Neto's 4 points definitely deserves a mention. You know he's 4, alongside Kendrick Brown. And FUS Rabat, their score line is a little bit deceptive because they went quiet towards the end of the second quarter.
Now the halftime stats, when we actually look at this, look, there's 0 from 11, you know, in the three-point department. So the outside is just not happening. And then inside, they're being stopped now because they've worked out how to actually defend.
The first thing that also stands out is the plus one rebounding difference. It's in favor of Petro de Luanda. They've done a pretty good job of controlling the defensive glass. They've also shared the ball better, which is something very rare because you never really get the opportunity to see FUS Rabat in full flow, but they have done a great job. Nadia Nakai entertaining the Kalahari Conference crowd, Robbie, and it is all happening out here at Sahara Arena.
We're absolutely loving it. One of many performers, and now we've got the crew who've just come onto court to join Nadia Nakai. Absolutely fantastic shows that we've had here in Pretoria, pre-halftime, and of course surrounding between games as well. It's been wonderful. Hopefully, and it will continue. I promise you that. We're going to take a small break. 34-46, Petro in charge.
Really, with the sound of the, it's kind of, hey! Luanda is a diversity town. That's what I call. People do love basketball here. Wherever you go, you will find a playground. I think Africa, Angola, Luanda, is the only place that like the street players, they get paid to play. That's so you can see, like, they take basketball real serious. Shield them down. He's a small kid, but he's a big kid too. He's a nice kid. He got a big heart. And he's still young. He's still very young. He's just the man here.
Sou Shield, tenho 24 anos, sou jogador do Petro de Luanda, sou casado, tenho um filho e sou um jogador profissional de basquetebol. Comecei a jogar basquete mesmo no Petro de Luanda, que é no, na sede do clube aqui no Eixo Viário. Foi o meu primeiro campo eu a jogar basquetebol. Aqui temos o Coach Quintino, Manuel Quintino. Foi um dos meus primeiros treinadores. Eu, quando comecei a jogar basquete, eles me receberam. Ainda me lembro que tínhamos um torneio em que ele é que nos comprou os equipamentos.
Fui um treinador muito exigente pelo Gil. Como eles passaram muito na mão, mas o Gil foi um treinador disciplinado. Pronto, eu perguntava nele, como é que tu queres aprender a jogar basquete? Pá, você é muito baixinho, pá. Mas aconteceu, vem e tal aqui, tá bem, pronto. E dei-lhe, você para jogar basquete tem que ser rápido. Tem que ser muito rápido. Então, aí comecei a treinar o Gil.
Basquetebol, pronto, para a nossa família, começou, pronto, ou se não. Na nossa família não tem alguém que já jogou base. Começaram de criança, primeiro no Shield, começou com 5 anos a treinar base. E aí foi desenvolvendo, fez júnior, fez cadete, júnior e até sênior.
That's the only way I'm on camera.
Hey!
With Shield.
Cash? I say.
Petro's family, like, everybody wants to win around here, you know? We're trying to build a dynasty where, like, losing ain't an option. We won the last three championships in Angola, and we want to keep that momentum going. Down is the heart of the team. You know, he's the guy who dictates the pace of the game. And I think we rely a lot on him to play the way we want to play. We want to play fast, we want to be aggressive, and he's just there.
É um exemplo de superação, na minha maneira de ver. E poucos são os jogadores que eu vi colocar tanto espírito para superar uma dificuldade. Claro que o basquete é uma modalidade onde os homens grandes, né? Os jogadores grandes levam muita vantagem, mas a gente vê também muito do que essa dificuldade pode ser um fator não limitante. E o Shield faz muita questão de, com o espírito, ele demonstrar que a altura não é um fator limitante para que ele possa jogar basquete e o basquete no alto nível.
Nós viemos a barbaria hoje, porque amanhã temos o Media Day, então tem que estar sempre fresh, que é para as fotos saírem bem.
estou, pronto, né? Feliz estou, né? Não esperar outra coisa e futuramente criar, pronto, né?
Basketball significa muito para mim, porque fez o homem que eu sou atualmente, deu-me várias coisas e eu sou grato pelo basquetebol. Dos melhores palcos, quer seja cá ou fora daqui, né? Porque o meu objetivo é sempre jogar o mais alto nível. E então eu me vejo sempre no topo de todos. Vou dar sempre o meu máximo para mim ser o melhor jogador da competição que eu vou.
Childa Dundari, small, super fast, and what a great playmaker, of course. We're going to take a small break. We'll be back and we'll analyze the first half, moving into the second half. 34-46, Petro lead.
I've been in my way out here, yeah, no, that's facts. You ain't living that you said, yeah, we know that's cap. You ain't got to ask me when you see me, no, I'm straight. DTOVO, we back again, going flat. Just a little 10-piece for it, just to blow it in the mall. Doesn't mean that we involved. I just put a Richard on the card. I ain't going to play a ball, but I show you how to got to do. If you really want to fall, take it five and you're back against the wall. And a bunch of need you to go away. Still going.
Welcome back to the SunBet Arena here in Pretoria, here in South Africa. Now, at the moment, there's a 12-point lead by Petro. We're going to take a look at this man, Mohamed Sylla. It makes me super happy to see a BAL Elevate player being one of the standout players in the first half of this giant battle.
8 points he scored, Robbie, and at 100% from the field, and he's picked up 6 rebounds, and he's done that with just 7 minutes on the court. He's providing great production for this FUS Rabat team, and he's done it in a variety of ways. Just look at the efficiency, and they say you can't teach height, but you can teach how to finish, and that's amazing finish from Sylla.
A wonderful West African connection there between Diarra and Sylla. Let's take a look at Abubakar Gakou now.
Hot hand, he did have 13 points on 40% shooting. Gakou trying to start out this half the same way.
He's still on court, going into the third quarter. Nelson. Oh, Moreira beautifully teed up and finished off. Double trouble there for Petro.
Looking to build on the momentum they built up in that second quarter. Great start for Petro.
Big three from the corner from Ken Brown.
Finally ends the drought from the outside. First connection from long range.
Big shot, KB.
That is something that Coach Said El-Bouzidi was looking for earlier in the game, that option from behind the arc.
Yeah, go outside. They haven't managed. That's their first three-pointer, I think, here.
That is their first three-pointer.
Look at that! Oh, done now! Whatever you can do, I can do better.
Well, he knocks down his second three-pointer, Childa Dundau. The sniper scope is certainly locked in.
Yeah, listen, you know, that report there at halftime when Jules and Neto just talking about, you know, basketball can be all about the big players, but some of the small ones they can actually deliver too. He is as fast as a cobra. And he scores big shots deep downtown across the border.
Hey, he is phenomenal as a basketball player and more renowned for his defense. But I think what we're starting to see unfold here in season four is the, his prominence on the offensive end.
He flies fast and he's not out of order. Usher, are you okay? What's happening over there? Where are you?
Just looking, you know, for the breaking news, but...
you don't have to have breaking news all the time. I put you under pressure. I do not want to put you under pressure. I need you to smile. I need you to be happy, in place, and enjoying yourself around this wonderful Basketball Africa League.
Incredible. I can tell you someone who's enjoying themselves. A 13-point lead for Petro de Luanda means Jose Neto can a little bit have some space to celebrate his side, but he knows there's a lot of work to be done in these two quarters.
Yeah, and you know, he sets a high standard, doesn't he, Jose Neto? If you actually think about what he's actually achieved. So he's made three semi-finals, remember, you know, in the first three seasons. They've qualified for every single one, as we see. JJ getting his second point there to make it 39-51. And, you know, so he wants Petro to go that far, even further this time.
And with this format, Robbie, and that's what we talk about, you see the opportunity to adjust, to adapt. It's no longer one and done. It's home and away, and this is a great adjustment by Petro.
Good use of the right arm to protect the ball from that man, Anthony Nelson, the American, doing well, especially when there was a few high trees around.
Finds the space to get the two.
Oh, it's a beautiful bucket there. Big, high, and dry shot there from JJ.
Second three ball. And now might force a little bit of adjustment from the zone that has been thrown at them all game.
Gaku for three as well. Oh, he loves that. That means the world to him.
Well, they might be giving up shots on the outside, but what they've not been able to do is contest Petro from the perimeter, and they're making them pay.
Crikey, going outside. It's all turned around. Turned upside down. We love it. Just look at this with Nelson with the drive. Get out of my way, Mr. Silla, because I can deal with this despite the fact that you're a giant. We're going to take a break.
At Rwandair, every flight is a journey of commitment. We prioritize the transportation of our customers' goods. Our cold storage facilities maintain freshness for perishables throughout the journey. Our warehouse is designed to handle a diverse range of goods with care and efficiency. Our team is committed to ensuring every aspect of your shipment is handled with precision and care. We comply with industry standards, implementing rigorous quality control measures to guarantee the safety and security of your cargo. Our fleet's cargo compartments provide ample space to accommodate a variety of products. We commit to timely delivery, ensuring your goods arrive fresh. From safely handling your cargo to providing updates, our team is always here for you.
We are now in Akagera National Park. It's the home of the Big Five.
I fell in love in Kigali. People like to enjoy life.
This was my dream since I was a kid, working with the gorillas every day.
There is something really magical about Nungwe National Forest. This is our little piece of heaven.
Rwanda is a place that everybody should really visit.
Welcome to Rwanda.
Well, we're back. Yes, here in Pretoria. Sunbet Arena, FUS de Rabat 42, Petro de Luanda 56. Get on the hashtag and the Instagram, the BAL, BAL4, all of it, get involved. Loads going on, guys. We're back on court and we can see that FUS de Rabat, we had a couple of exchanges with 3 points, and now we find ourselves, you know, back with a 14-point lead for Petro de Luanda. Jose Neto must be very happy, Q.
It's kind of a give and take situation, because what has happened is that FUS are able to actually hit a couple of threes where it might force the defensive shift, but what Petro have done on the other side is reply from long range as well. So we get to see a little bit more of that life's high-speed chess that I like to talk about.
High-speed chess, there you go. Motorized chess, there it is, hanging high. I love the way that it was just held up in the air. It goes down. Fine score from Nuhi.
He gets inside, floats up and over the defense, and that is a beautiful finish from Nuhi.
The silky touch Asha Kumigisha has also got lots of information for us. I'm not going to put you on in the limelight too much. I'm just going to say, how are you? A simple and open question.
Perhaps I'm as fine as Jose Neto right now. He's emphasizing, you know, the team needs to continue with that three ball. They're 5-4-13 behind the arc. A little bit better than FUS Rabat, who are 2-4-13. And that's sort of, you know, the difference here for this double-digit lead.
Gaku's high and dry effort doesn't put the points on the scoreboard as that man, Ayub Nuhi, goes up and he tries to use the glass, but watch out, Dundao is on the attack. Charging up, that is just the best you can possibly ask for from the Angolan master.
He turns on the afterburners going down the floor in transition, Dundao, beautiful, beautiful two.
Long shot from John Jordan that doesn't fall. Dundao picks it up. Petro again. Ujona Pedro. Gaku. Watch out for the quick click into gear from Dundao. Goes out wide. Carlos Moraes. Carlos Moraes has got 3 points on the board today, but it hasn't been about him as there's a big charge and attempt to try and smash that in from Gaku.
Children are now in his speed down the floor, turns on the afterburners, and that is a superb finish. Don't look at his size, look at the points in the points column.
It's precision scoring, isn't it? That's, you're the man, you are the man, Dundao. Love the guy, he's bringing so much great basketball to Angola, to the national team as well. Of course, 14-point lead Petro have going into the, well, 6.5 minutes left in the third.
They've just kept it around this 14-point mark. And every time FUS have tried to make a push back, Petro have had a reply.
It's a reverse scenario, of course, from the first encounter that they played, because it was FUS who actually had the advantage. Oh, that's fantastic shooting from Ken Brown.
Well, they're looking to unlock Ken Brown now from the perimeter. It's his third make. And between Jordan and Brown, I think the backcourt is going to try and shoot their way out of trouble.
Dundao. Dundao drives. Floats it high. It's a great score from Dundao again.
So skillful is Childe Dundao. Gets inside, floats it up, over and in.
14 points for him. Ken Brown. Saitata Nui. Nui goes up, rolls off and out. Nelson. Dundao down in the corner. Waits for the cavalry to arrive. Jona Pedro back to Nelson. Nelson under a little bit of pressure. Shot clock down to single digits as he tries to find a way past the big man's reach out. Dundao, the danger man, Dundao!
You would never bet against him in that position. Given all the scoring we've seen, Childe Dundao is a man on fire.
On fuego big time. Jordan.
17 Childe Dundao points.
Ken Brown out to Nui. A little dancing by Jordan, tries to get the ball back, 5 seconds on the clock. Johnny Pedro just putting a bit of pressure on him, needs to get a shot in, goes for a big three. The three doesn't find its way, and Dundao picks it up. He's back on track, Dundao. And you can see Jordan's left on the ground there. And then he goes to haul him back up onto his feet. It's an offensive foul.
The blocking foul is called. And look at the shifty work of Nelson. Creates space for Dundao to knock down an open three. He's had answers inside and outside. And we've just seen him open his offensive bag up and take out all of the tools.
They've been thrown onto the court just like that. And he's going, which one am I going to use today? That one, this one, mixing it up big time.
7 of 10 at 70% from the field. He's put on a clinic.
That's like a stat from your days, isn't it, Q? When you were like sort of, you know, wild and rampant on the court. Nice turn! Big in, big, smashing down. Dunk there from Tiara.
Lob threat extraordinaire, and that is a great find, the connection between Zuita and Tiara.
I think he deserves a new name, Air Marshal. Air Marshal Aludiara.
That is just massive, isn't it? I think there were tremors, earthquake tremors after that one hit. Dundao, oh, he's gone. Oh, he's been hooked out. Is there a foul on him? He gets him with the ground after being hit by Diarra, but went looking for it. The 3 points, what a big score that is.
Goes up to 20. Childe Dundao has the hot hand.
He's delivering, and his coach, Jose Neto, must be super proud of him because everything is turning to gold. Just look at that. How high?
He made the adjustment for the outstretched hand, but at this point, no matter what he puts up, it won't miss, and that goes glass. And the bank here at Sunbet Arena is open.
That's not an outstretched arm. That's 2.7 meters, and then the wingspan.
And then the wingspan.
Oh, come on.
The shortest man in the Basketball Africa League.
Come on. What else can you say about it?
I don't have anything else.
Oh, okay. All right, well, it went high. Look at this. Ooh. Oh, look at that. That's just, he swooped in and made sure that that was a big score.
Sweet, yeah. Stating his case as one of the best passing bigs in the league.
Carlos Moraes, offensive foul. Offensive charge there, 15-point lead. FUS to Rabat get possession. These are the moments. Fourth personal for Moraes. Concerning moments. He's been other players who have been coming into the limelight on this Petro team. And Carlos Moraes, 3 points, four fouls.
Well, he hasn't needed to step up in the way that he has in previous games. Other players are happy to pick up the scoring low, but I still need him on the floor for his presence, his decision-making. And sometimes his defense, he's a threat that helps to space the floor. This is a big moment. He goes off, and in comes Gonzalez.
Yeah, but just look at this. We've got two players who are not coming in. Edmir Lucas, of course, and Eduardo Simão. You've also got Marquise Cummings, who was excluded at the very start in the first quarter. Now Carlos Moraes under a little bit of pressure. Give the ball to Nelson. Nelson going up all by himself. Oh, that's fantastic defense. Look at that.
Two consecutive blocks, double.
Oh, goes in, Diarra! Smash! Smash and grab and score! 53-66, Diarra, oh wow!
What an amazing sequence from this FUS Rabat team. The two defensive stops on the other side, Diarra stops it home.
Nelson, oh, he just couldn't take the pass, Pedro, they go again. And this is FUS to Rabat trying to react big time. No, he gets the ball in, so he tries to go around the back. And there's a bit of contact, and Gakou, well, he's just screaming because it's an offensive foul.
You look at the defense from now. The follow-up from Gakou, he thought he had it. Zuita said, no, not this time. Clears it out, and they get up on the other side. The speedster, Ken Brown, waits. And there's the man, Diarra. And you're talking about air traffic control. He was cleared for takeoff.
There's nothing stopping him there. That man can fly. .240 left to play. Dundao, taking on the big man. Oh, he just gets nudged. Doesn't score. Oh, there we go. This is stop by Gakou. The defensive game from Gakou. Look at this, Dundao. Out to Nelson. Nelson decides to go in. No, he doesn't. Gakou drops it in. Oh, how about that? It was talking about poetry in motion again.
We're literally seeing some great defensive sequences from both these teams, and they're turning turnovers into points.
Nui. Ken Brown, oh, Zuita goes in, he gets the second chance off the glass, doesn't happen, third chance, lucky, no, it doesn't happen again, it is into the hands of Nelson, Petro Luanda, wait patiently, you've got big men coming up, Johnny Petro might get it, no, he doesn't, it's Gakou again, Gakou for two.
Lots of poise, composure on that from Nelson, and Gakou waited for Diarra to come, got into his chest, and was able to get the finish.
Hey, a team that work together well, don't need the likes of Carlos Moraes when you got these players who are on fire. There's an attempt to try and get that in. Gakou's again, the player just tidying things up in the paint defensively, playing an awesome game so far. Gonçalves has possession.
Been a stunning performance from Petro de Luanda. They've had control of the tempo and pace of this game for large portions of it.
Starting to see the Petro de Luanda that we've seen in previous BALs has done that once again. Goes on a little bit of a weaving maneuver and draws a bit of attention. Usher, we need to come to you because, well, our voices are going to go.
Well, I know whose voice is going to go. It's the Petro de Luanda bench. They're enjoying every minute of this game, the end-to-end action. And obviously, you know, animated players like Yannick Moreira love to, you know, cheer on their teammates. They need that sort of energy, and it's working for them so far.
Look, there's Gakou. Gakou with a demolition job. 20 points, 6 rebounds, 58% of field goals percent. So you can see that, you know, he's just like Dundau. They've both been brandishing all of the armory that they possibly can, and it's all producing the goods. It's all working tonight.
Well, you get the feeling that they got rattled in that first game, Q. You get the feeling that today is all about revenge, but really they know that if they win this game comfortably, they have one foot in Kigali.
They certainly do, and again, I want to go back to the opportunity to punch back, you know, the home and away, a second bite at the cherry that we have not had that over the first three seasons. The adjustments are made, and you get to see what the coaches are able to do and the desire of the players on the floor.
So it goes on head-to-head, you know, results, of course, on who finishes first and second. And if Petro win by more than 9 points, then they've got a good chance of putting themselves in that top position, of course. So this is where they are at the moment. They go up, and Ken Brown, beautiful two. You're going high on the glass, staying away from the tentacles of the big man in the paint. Into the last minute we go, 55-72. But I think that there's also, well, Dundau going down, contact by Ben Mahin. I think we also got to look at the fact that, you know, it might not be a revenge scenario, but more so Petro Luanda looking inside of themselves and how they can play and how they can, you know, improve their game. And they've done that in a big way today.
They are two teams with great championship heritage. FUS Rabat have won 18 division titles and league titles in league excellence. You have the Angolan champions who've done it 16 times. It there's heritage of champions here, and we're seeing championship blood go at each other.
It's like you, Q. You've got winning DNA inside of your body, and you know how to win. Of course, these guys have got that as well. Nelson going up. Shot clock is down to the last second, and it's being picked up here by Jordan. Jordan races, paces, moves into. A beautiful one at that. A good score there from Azuga.
The universe almost willing that one in as it twists and turns and falls and gives 2 points, much needed two.
Charge from Gonsalves into the happen. Pass goes out, and the shot on the Salada. Nelson a three!
Was almost too relaxed on that play. He saw the shot clock, saw the state of the game, and he got a shot off in a comfortable fashion, and he's just set the building alight, Nelson.
Up to 9 points. Look at that. That is just that's a rainbow shot in the rainbow nation. It doesn't get better than that.
Quick little look up, sees the game clock, fires the shot away, and it's nothing but net.
Booster about 57, Petro 75. Small break. We will be back.
At the Kalahari.
57-75, Sunbet Arena, Pretoria, place to be. Let's take a look at the game summary so far, Q.
It has definitely been so fascinating, the assist scoring numbers going up now, but still Petro plus 4 ahead in this assist category, 39% and 57 points. And we saw 3 shots finally go down from the perimeter in, and Pusta Rabat trying to fight their way back, but 8 of 17 is, as Petro de Luanda's long-range shooting continues to reign supreme, but they've spread the ball continually well. Dundao and Gaku combining for 42 points, and it has been a show for real here at the Sunbet Arena.
This has been a fabulous advert for African basketball. The Basketball Africa League Season 4 at its best. Sublime and monumental action taking place here in Pretoria. Asha Kumagisha, we're going to come to you. What was the chit-chat going on regarding the timeout?
Yeah, Coach Said El Bouzidi wants FUS Rabat to continue passing that ball. He wants to see ball movement. They have 12 team assists so far, but he wants more from them. But also he wants them to penetrate into that paint and see if they can get some of those points on the free throw line. They're 16 for 19 so far, and they know that their efficiency can help them going into this last quarter.
Thank you, Asha. 38 points in the paint for Petro, only 28 for FUS Rabat. To give you an idea, sort of, you know, where it's going, they've had to come out wide and they've hit their first 3-pointers, of course, but this is a game of change. It's a game of adjustments, because there's a lot of tactical decisions taking place from the two coaches, and they're moving and shuffling things around depending on where they are at that point of the game.
Mostafa Rabat averaging around about 49 points per game, points in the paint per game coming into this one.
The demolition job! Dundao, well, it's Boyamba, he gets some points finally, and he'll be happy to get his second pair of points there.
He floated it up and over. Dundao, Boyamba right there on the follow to pick up 2 and take his total up to 4.
And how, oh, he loses his possession there. Oh, it's a demolition job for Dundao. Oh, yes, indeed. Bring it on.
Gets in front of the defender. Excellent use of his body and athleticism, and this time finishes with his left hand.
Need to react. Yoita. Ben Mahin sees a little bit of space. Natcha goes up, tries to pass Gaku. It wasn't possible. The defensive game from Gaku has been up there and off the charts today.
So has that man, Childa Dundao.
Gonsalves, Gaku gets the ball back. 3-point shot from Gonsalves. Picked up by Gaku, they go again. Boyamba, the big charge. Oh, it's just rolled off. Made safe by Zuita. And El Hawa picks it up, gets it out wide to Jordan. Jordan drives in. That is just brilliant. The acceleration from Jonathan Jordan was out of this world.
Best athlete on the continent going at it, and John Jordan comes in with his history of athleticism, and he showcases it right there.
He won the NBA G League dunk contest, you know, a few years ago. So just to give you an idea of his lift and his spring-like ability to come off the ground like a human trampette. Good charge going through by Ben Mahin, and he's found himself going to the free throw line for a pair of shots.
This is a great way for them to try and make inroads into this lead, but it's a significant lead that Petro have been able to build. They need to stop the clock, and they've got to get a couple more stops and maybe even knock down some long-range shots just to get back in this one.
You know, I'm seeing the body language of Said El Bouzidi. He knows that, you know, these are the kind of games that he's going to come up against if they get themselves into the finals, of course, in Kigali. And he knows that he has to understand how to break this down. You can see that, Usher, right? You can see the body language. They've never been in this position before, remember, because they won their first 2 games.
Yeah, and that can sometimes, you know, affect the psychology of the players, but they know that they have to earn every point that they score here in the Kalahari Conference. They're coming up against a team that has a lot of veterans that have played at this level before, but they respect them, but they will keep fighting in this game.
No, they are fighting, and that's a good point. They will not stop fighting, because they're on a mission, you know, just talking to them and understanding sort of, you know, what their mindset is. They want to go all the way.
And it gives more value to the games against the Cape Town Tigers that remain for both of these clubs. They've got to pick up wins, and they've got to do it in the right fashion.
Nelson's shot. Not hitting the target. Alawa gets the ball out to Jordan. Jordan tries to sneak between trees, goes up. Oh, that's a beautiful put, and Diarra finally in the right place to make sure that that is going down.
A rare opportunity for some freedom inside the paint. You can't leave him alone. You know that he's going to be up there in terms of the rebounding category. And put back dunk, courtesy of Diarra.
There it is. That's in. That's definitely in. Diarra scoring and making it 6 points. So not the high-scoring game that we're used to seeing from Diarra, of course. This is going... Oh, it's been blocked there. Diarra's trying to say...
A case of contact, perhaps, on the body, and Diarra's unhappy with the way that that was interpreted, but...
Yeah, they want to check out and sort of, you know, go and understand what that was all about, so they're just going to...
Well, they're trying to... influenced the decision there from referee Arnold Mosea, but he insists it is shooting two, and there will not be no need of looking at the video review.
Yeah, no review. That's thank you, Asha. Decision's been made.
Reviews and challenges, or coaches' challenges, are not allowed. The referees will make decisions around when to trigger the official review system.
But it doesn't stop them from trying to get their way.
There are 14 different triggers. We'll have to get into that as we continue to cover the games.
14 triggers. There you go. Here, if you can get them all in the space of 24 seconds, then, you know, I'll let you go.
Okay.
Not now.
Challenge accepted.
Well, not now, but another time. Here we go. It's 63-81. Jordan. Zoita goes right through the middle and collides into Angolan traffic. Will go to the free throw line.
This is an interesting phase in play. They continue to have the ability to draw the fouls and get to the free throw line. The free throw line has not been great for them throughout competition, but they are doing a better job today, and they've got to continue to do that. A couple more stops. This game certainly will become interesting.
We've seen quite a few threes in the land of the big five here in South Africa, of course, and some wonderful shooting in today's encounter. I think you've got to really understand that, you know, this is a high-octane encounter. There's a lot at stake in this battle here, because these are teams who have already won, and they're trying to close in on one of those very lucrative spots in Kigali for the finals.
Undefeated in group play so far, FUS, and, you know, the Angolan champions are trying to make sure that they state their case to go up top. 87%, as I was saying, just their conversion rate from the free throw line has been really good.
87% each. Jean Pedro Gonçalves drives in. Boyamba goes around. Oh, the shot clock down to three. Nelson needs to produce a floater. The floater doesn't find its way. And El Hawa picks it up down into the corner. Ben Mahin. Oh, it's underneath there. It's going to be Diarra. Diarra. It's an easy place. Two there for Diarra.
Well, Gaku did it a little bit earlier on. Diarra this time, he shows composure, patience, and real skill to get the finish.
42 points in the paint for Petro de Luanda. Gonçalves, Johnny Pedro swipes, snatches the ball. Nelson trying to get rid of El Hawa. Shot clock down to five, gets rid of his man. Oh, get out of there, Diarra. But there was a foul.
Diarra, he just knows how to utilize his athleticism to make it. His presence felt inside the paint, and whether the block is legal or not, it's a message. You look at the skill of Nelson. He goes to his right hand, the contact on the ball, and Diarra says, nah, not this time.
It's El Hawa who makes contact there, and I think with the slap on the wrist, and that will be his second foul. As we see Nelson go up, Nelson's got a very nifty, sneaky way of getting rid of his, you know, defensive marker. I love the footwork, but he moves his body in a way that you just don't know which way he's going to go. El Hawa was left for dust a moment ago.
He's what we call a shifty player. His ability to first go, should move in different directions, and his front line foot speed is impressive.
Shifty. That means sketchy where it comes from. You know, shifty, shift your body, move it over. Yeah, exactly. That's exactly what he did. Wonderful play from a great player, Nelson. There's Diarra, goes out wide. Ben Mahin chucks, gets rid of Dundao, tries to drop it in. It's made safe by Pedro. How much do we got left? 5.5 minutes, 16-point advantage. But Booster Rabat is still fighting valiantly, aren't they, Hugh?
They certainly are not out of it. A couple more stops and scores, and we could see a significant scoring run make this one interesting.
Dundao, 24 points, goes through the middle, goes really high, unable to get the points, and there, Diarra falling over. And he was, it's as though Dundao was looking for the foul against him when he went for that shot. And it's not going to be called, it's just going to be the possession back in the hands of Fuster Rabat. And he just got tangled up afterwards, so we'll get a reaction from the officials in a moment.
Well, there the foul is called by crew chief Ken Faye. Up he goes, this Dundao. He clashes with Diarra in the air, which happens. It's legal as long as you're not impeding the space. And now we have a look. He closes the leg on the... He closes his legs on Diarra's leg, and that might be scaled up just a little bit to an unsportsmanlike foul.
Yeah, it was a little bit of a tit-for-tat scenario, so Dundao might get an unsportsmanlike, potentially.
He most definitely might get that unsportsmanlike. The officials, after it becomes very clear on the review, I expect that they probably will, because, again, it's about the spirit of the game and also intent in terms of making an attempt for the ball, and you know how that can be interpreted and seeing the visuals that we just saw.
Yeah, I mean, it's very clear for us, you know, we saw it. Usher is all over this, so we'll catch up with her in a minute when she's ready, but you know, you can see that the officials just making sure that that they may come out with the right decision, that they have been up to this point and doing a sterling job. 67-83.
Referee Arnold Moseya, South African referee, having a look there and chatting alongside Ken Fahey, and we get the benefit of a second and third look here as well. And one thing prolonged breaks like this can do is just shift momentum a little bit.
Well, it will not be upgraded to an unsportsmanlike foul. It is a normal foul and possession for FUS Rabat.
Thank you, Asha. There you go, confirmation. Well, it's, I mean, you know, that's the final decision, and we just got to live with it. 67-83.
Officials made the decision. They keep it going.
We follow them.
We do.
Because we can't do their job like they do. I can't. I definitely can't. I know Asher wants to be one.
Well, I suggest you speak for yourself, Robbie.
Here we go, Ben Mahin. And what, 5 minutes remaining here, fourth quarter. The battle continues here between Fuster Rabat, the Moroccan champion. You give the ball away to Dundao. He will take it every single time. Gonsalves takes the pass. Oh, that wasn't brilliant. And Gonsalves gets it back. Can't get his shot. And it's picked up here, Jordan. Jordan, watch out for Jordan. He's going to go all the way. No, he isn't. To the right there. And that is a great score. A wonderful score there from Azuga. What a pass. What a pass.
Very little Dundao could do with Azuga attacking the rim in transition. He gave a valiant effort, got up high, but the arm was outstretched, and the bigger body, Azuga, got the finish.
Jose Neto. Now a Brazilian coach here at the helm. And lead Petro to the final, another final. Lost against Monastir, of course. And they would love get themselves into that final. We'll take a small break. 69-83, 14 points. That can change at any time. We'll be back in a moment. So we're about 69, Petro Luanda 83 as we enter 4:34 left in this final quarter. Get on all of these socials, of course, the Insta, the Twitter, all the rest of it, hashtag BAL4. This is all happening now. Fast and furious encounter between Giants and Giants. First time Giants for FUS Rabat here in the BAL.
They've clawed their way back into this one, and there's still an eternity left in terms of time, and they are fighting tooth and nail to be in the conversation in the final 2 minutes.
100% from the free throw line for both teams so far. As a player goes down, Bowie Amber, and gives us a chance to go and talk to Asha. Asha, what's going on?
Coach Jose Neto is really, you know, he wants Petro de Luanda to play with more intensity. They want to, you know, run down that clock. They know they had a 19-point game so far in this game, but now it's 13 points. They have to be very careful because FUS Rabat have what it takes to overturn this game in the last 4 minutes.
You know what? You've got a very good point. If ever you've got a team who will take advantage of any openings, I think it's FUS Rabat. I think that they're the team that you've got to really watch out for, and they're going to be difficult to beat. They make it through to the finals in Kigali. Watch out for these guys, because they got a bench, they work well together, and they got that fighting spirit.
The only thing that they might have to look at is outside shooting. Perimeter shooting has been difficult for them here in Pretoria.
Jordan, 70-84, 1 point onto the pile there for Petro Luanda. Elawa goes in, trying to find Diarra, doesn't find him in the paint. Gonsalves picks it up, not the right number 10. Nelson, 11 points, one of three, four players in double figures. Nelson goes up, Diarra deals with it defensively.
Oh, that is fantastic timing from Aliyu Diarra. Second block, the legal block that he's credited for.
Jordan. There it is. Zuita trying to go up, chucks it back out. Picked up there, Jordan for the mid-range two.
And once again, some really good patience, and Diarra goes to ground hard. And it looked like there was just a little bit of an off-the-ball incident. Very hard to tell. Right, we just saw the late reaction from Diarra, who fell to the ground.
And then we've got to take a look. We'll take a look. There it is. That's the block. Get out. That's mine. Okay, you're in. That's my turf. Now look at this.
And here we have a look again. And the different angles just give you more appreciation for the skill that it takes to block. Remember that he led the BAL in blocks in 2023, and it looks like he's recovered. Fourth block that was.
Yeah, we've seen. Now this is him, he's getting, he's just been hit there by Jonet Petro, he's just backed into him, and
And it caused a little moment of pain as he goes.
Well, they were able to shake hands there real quick and recognize that it was not intentional. Shows you the brotherhood there on the court.
Accidental. It's just, you know, this is, it's a physical game, you know. Q tries to convince me that it's a very physical game sometimes. But, you know, I sometimes believe him. Sometimes.
Please believe him.
No, we know it's super physical. Mega exciting. Nelson gets it out wide. Gonsalves goes up for a big three-pointer. It just comes off the metal and back out. Dundau, of course, Speedy Gonzalez of Angolan basketball. Takes the ball, deals with it.
12 offensive rebound. They've done a great job catching the glass, and that's going to be an illegal screen. Oh, kickball by Johnny Pedro.
And that just plays back into the hands of Fuster Rabat. The trouble is, there's only 2 minutes 46 left on the clock.
And that is an illegal screen, the use of the leg from Johnny Pedro, and that the call comes in from referee Ken Fahey.
See, Ben Maheen just taken out of the equation, just to give Dundau time to get his shot in. Here he is, Ben Maheen in possession. Need to get points, need to also draw attention, go to the free throw line. They're at 100% going into the fourth quarter. Picked up by Zuita. Goes out wide. Jordan for three.
Fantastic ball movement and patience. They went deep into the shot clock to get Jordan wide open. No defense coming out. And he took his time, composed himself, and made an important shot.
And for the first time in a very long time, it's under 10 points. Look at that. That is just grandiose, isn't it?
And selfish basketball. Get your shooter wide open. You see him set the ball in his hands, releases it, and that one is pure poetry.
He had enough time to wink at his friends, you know, sort of, you know, wave at some fans in the stands, and then get his shot in. That's where you want to be.
And maybe some cause for concern now, and that's why the call for the timeout here from Coach Jose Neto, as you mentioned, Robbie. It goes back within 3 possessions. It's a 9-point game, and it gets really intriguing now in these final 2 minutes 30.
Yeah, it's all about, you know, game management, tactics as well. These coaches will be like sort of saying exactly what they want to do, which players they want out on the court as well, you know, going into, you know, the last couple of minutes, because it's tight. Let's have a look at the stats here, Q.
Brown and Jordan, the backcourt for FUS Rabat, fighting their way back. It's Aliou Diarra's chipped in with his 8-7, Silla's 8-6. And even on a poor shooting day for Jonathan Jordan, he keeps them in it. But Dindao and Gaku combining for that 44 points at high efficiency and 8 Gaku rebounds inside. I just tell you what a fantastic day it has been for him inside the paint.
Right, taking a look at you know, 2 of the main players out there today, and especially that man Dundau, 24 points, best tally so far. That's high press here taking place as we enter the last couple of minutes. Very soon, 2:15. Dundau, Nelson, Gaku. He's trying to find his teammates in space under a little bit of pressure here. Nelson picks it up. Ken Brown trying to roll off Ken Brown. Finally, Gonsalves picks it up for 3. Shot. Oh, that's just not good enough. And it's been made safe by Diarra.
It was another good possession, finding the wide open shooter. And he scrambled for it. Sees Ken Brown looked like he got the last touch trying to keep the ball alive. So it will be Petro de Luanda basketball.
Well, just a couple of instructions there from Coach Said El Bouzidi, emphasizing on the need to intensify their defense. That's why you see them picking Petro de Luanda man for man. They don't want to leave any excuse on the court today.
It's all about that. Now we have a very intense finale. Now we have, like, sort of, you know, everything counts here. You talk about the small things in a basketball game, it's now that it really matters.
Team that executes best generally comes away with the win.
Gonsalves. Nelson has it in his hands. Tightly marked there by Ken Brown. Tries to go around him. Oh, he's had a few problems, but he uses his strength, gets the shot in. Oh, it comes back out to Gaku. But
shot clock goes off. The officials are calling for another 14 seconds. And the refresh
didn't happen inside the arena, but the Petro de Luanda will keep the possession.
Officials very quick to react to that.
Very experienced officials, and they'll know just how to keep calm, especially as the temperaments run high here down the stretch.
Yeah, they've got a lot of pressure on their shoulders too, because this is money time, isn't it? Oh, it's been picked up. Dundau, he goes. Look how quick he is. Oh, that's nearly just gone over the top there. Who did it touch? It's going to be Petro in possession.
And that's the value of having a defender like Diarra inside the paint. Dundau was anticipating the contest. He almost overcompensated. Fortunately for him, last touch comes off the defender. But you just understand what having a defender like Diarra inside the paint means.
Petro. Dundau goes up.
And that's going to be a shot clock violation.
Violation, yeah. Wow, this is very tense and tight. Now, let's have a look. Ben Maheen.
Yeah, he's been given a technical foul there, and it will be shooting for Petro there and Dundau.
Yeah, it's Ben Maheen who goes in, and you can see that there's just a little bit of contact with his hand. And hence the reason why he's but Gaku's going up for the free throw line.
He must have said something to the official.
He said something actually to Dundau.
Oh, to Dundau.
See, those are the moments, the little lapse of concentration. All of these fine details. They're important, aren't they?
They managed to string together a couple of great defensive possessions that could shift momentum.
Got herself back out. Jordan for three. Oh, it's a beautiful bucket. Sensational.
Big time shot. Big time shot from Jordan.
7 points. Minutes left to play. Gaku under pressure. Got to go looking for it now. It's not going to come to you unless you don't get your hands on it. Nelson. Does well, really well. They need to turn this into points. Jordan picks it up. Another 3 points are coming his way, potentially. Who knows? Brown gets it out to Ben Maheen. Ben Maheen, Jordan. Jordan for a shot. They got to go. 8 seconds. Ben Maheen back out. And there's Azorga for three. It's a stunning 3-point shot down in the corner. And look at the reaction from the FUS players coming off the bench.
Once again, patience on the offensive end, making the extra pass, finding the shooter wide open in the corner, and all of a sudden, they've started to find their range and their touch, and it's a 4-point game.
Timeout calls, and of course, that will give them just enough time to just adjust and work out what they're going to do next. This is sensational.
What a stunning fight back it's been from FUS to Rabat. They trailed by as much as 20 points, and now in this final little minute, or this final minute of the contest, it is a two-possession game. It's a 4-point game, and a good defensive position for FUS might see them get back within one.
Yeah, 19-point lead they had at one point, Q. Which is exactly the same, but you just get the impression that, you know, Petro not being tight enough for those crucial moments, but it's also FUS Rabat who've been really fighting hard, as we see Childe Dundau's stats for the day.
He's gone a bit quiet here in the fourth quarter in terms of his scoring, but 24 points, 53%. He's been dynamic on both ends of the floor. We've seen him unlock levels in his offensive game, and it's been fun to witness inside and outside. He's been absolutely dynamic.
And talking about dynamic, Coach Said El Bouzidi has, you know, emphasized his players that they need to get that ball in the hands of Jordan. He's the man with the fire hands at the moment, and he could get them across the line. It's just 30 seconds to go. Let's see if they'll get this one.
Thank you, Asha. It's all about the hot hands, isn't it? Jordan, Dundau, the battle of those, the playmakers, those wonderful flashy speedsters who have been lighting up this wonderful court here in Pretoria.
Well, he has three of the 6 made threes, does Jordan, in the second half. They were ice cold in the first, and they'll be willing and hoping that he can get one more.
Kaku takes the pass there from Dundau. Need to get possession. Shot, the clock is going down, of course. 25 seconds remaining. Mr. Rabat needs to try and react. Moraes picks it up. He's coming on. Long-range shot. Oh! Moraes! What a moment for magical Moraes! At the other end, oh, there's two there for that man, Azuga. This is sensational.
Quick score back the other way. Big-time shot from Moraes, and there is contact call, frustration everywhere from the first Rabat players.
Petro Luanda will get possession, and it is a foul that's been committed. Just look at that! Look at it!
Big moment, Angolan legend, sharp shooting, Carlos Moraes knocks down an important three, his only three in this one.
That's the crazy thing, he's only just come back on. He picked up four fouls, you know, earlier on, you know, in the third quarter. And, you know, we haven't seen him since. He comes on and he does that.
Well, it's called money time players. And Carlos belongs to that class.
Most decorated player. One of the most decorated players in Africa. The Angolan magnifique Carlos Moraes. And Dundau up to the free throw line.
With just 5 seconds left, there's a clock pressure here. An important trip to the free throw line. Dundau has got to get at least one.
Well, he so far has 24 points, a game high so far. He'll definitely finish as the highest scorer today.
Oh, let's give him 25, shall we, Asha?
That's it, 25 it is.
And a timeout's been called, 83-89. 6 points, 5.1 seconds remaining. You just get the end. You're taking a look at this, Q, and you're saying, this is what the BAL is all about.
Well, you saw the spirit of fight back from the BAL debutants in the season, Fus Rabat. And what we're going to see coming out of this 5 seconds is a search for a quick shot. They're going to find an execution on the advance on the sideline out of bounds. And then maybe a quick foul just to send and put some pressure on the free throw shooter to go back up the other way. Maybe three or four more possessions still await us. And we're going to see some excellence here for certain.
Now, the thing is that Petro Luanda, if they win this by more than 9 points, then they put themselves in a favorable position in the head-to-head count. But if they don't, Fus Rabat will be in their driving seat. We've still got games to play, of course, but I'm just saying.
It's certainly a note and a side note worth putting up there. And we have another look at that long-range bomb. And the importance of just staying ready off the bench is not lost on Carlos Moraes.
Listen, he's part of the constellation of stars that we actually have here at the BAL, but he very much is the man at the top of the table at the moment, because that has basically nudged them towards victory.
How many more chapters do we have to write in this already awesome story of Carlos Moraes?
He's just brilliant, and we love to have him here in the BAL. And we know that, you know, he's not a young pup.
No, not at all.
But he probably will come back for as long as he can play. We've seen them with some of the Angolan players, of course. Olympio was 41 when he was playing last year.
And this hyperbolic chamber that seems to exist for athletes nowadays.
There you go. It's called loving life, isn't it? Goes up for three. Oh! Stunning shot there from Jordan. 86-89. But that's it. It comes to an end. Petro Luanda take the win. But what a showdown, what a monumental moment for the BAL. Fus Rabat showing resilience and battling back. They couldn't quite nick it. Petro Luanda beat them 89-86 to go to 2-3. And Fus Rabat are also on 2-3.
What a fantastic show of character, spirit, basketball execution, individual greatness and offense. Now we saw some great front court and back court battles. There's a BAL basketball of the highest accord.
And you saw that Dundau and Ken Brown battling for the ball. Ken Brown said, okay, you can have it. It's, you know, you have it, because the 25 points of that performance was just off the charts. Extraordinary from him. And we will get a reaction from Abubakar Gakou.
Abu Bakar Gakou, félicitations, vous avez gagné. Mais qu'est-ce qu'on retient?
Yeah, you won this, but what will you take from this? The win from tonight or the goal average that doesn't allow you to finish top? Yeah, it's a good win for us. Yep. We won, but we didn't win by more than 9 points, which was what we wanted to do. So it's the win. It's the win that counts. Today, we found the real Abu Bakar Gakou with 21 points. How did he play this game? Weren't ready in the first game. And they hit us hard in the first game. So today we came here focused. Yeah, and it's that. And we came with the force of this team.
Vous n'êtes pas dit, ça y est, c'est gagné, vous avez un peu baissé les bras.
That big lead, did you think, oh yes, done, it's a done deal? Yeah, we just dropped our guard a little bit, and it wasn't good for us. But we just got the win, and we need to focus on this.
Bon, félicitations, vous avez gagné quand même. Merci beaucoup.
Abu Bakar Gakou with his reaction there, 86-89, but crikey, what a finish that was. And all credit to FUS Rabat, who gave us a real entertaining game there.
They started to find that identity that they have created in terms of sharing the basketball, making the extra pass, giving up a good shot for a great shot, and they continued to battle on the boards. The key difference was the 7 made threes in the second half that allowed them to get back. The zone was frustrating them in the first half, and they shot their way out of the zone to become competitive in the second. And what a fight back it was, but the Angolan champions, just a better team on the day.
You know, when you think about the 9 points, you know, lead between the two teams, well, I don't think that we need to actually sort of, you know, look at that too much, because at the moment we're just looking at the teams who actually qualify for Kigali. Whoever plays whoever in Kigali in the finals, it will always be a difficult matchup anyway. All you want to do is get out of the Kalahari Conference as one of the two, potentially three teams.
And you remember that part of the new format is actually the seeding procedure and the seeding tournament that's going to take place a little bit later in Kigali before they get the chance to play. But it's victory for Petro de Luanda, the Angolan champs, as they come away with an important win. And they've certainly made sure that it keeps the game, the next couple of games, so fascinating.
Well, FUS Rabat, 86-89 against Petro de Luanda. Cape Town Tigers next up against Petro de Luanda. And then FUS Rabat again against Cape Town Tigers. These are the final fixtures, battles that will take place as we find out who will go through from the Kalahari Conference. But tonight, it was a night we saw wonderful basketball here in the BAL. This basically was the highlight of what we've seen so far. A wonderful battle back, but not enough to topple the giants of Angola, Petro de Luanda, who sneak past and get themselves 2 wins from 3 to match up with FUS Rabat, who have 2 from 3. Pure entertainment, Q.
Entertainment of the highest accord. What a fantastic game, and what a night it has been in the Kalahari Conference and SunBet Arena. Stand up, it was beautiful basketball.
Q, Usher and the team, thank you so much. It's been an absolute dream. We're going to come back a day after tomorrow, rest day tomorrow, and then we come back for another colossal showdown. Big time battles galore here in the Kalahari Conference in this wonderful city of Pretoria. Goodbye, see you then. Bye bye.